Alright everybody, welcome back to my stream. I'm going to finish my painting that I started yesterday. Enjoy the music. It shouldn't be too loud now. Painting in the light at this point with a slight yellow. I can't read that. I don't understand Cyrillic at all. So, fabric is a surface, has a surface with a high surface area, so it's very it's scattering the light more, and therefore you have more of a more like the light energy scattered more and less of specularity. Okay, so I have no shadow here. I might change that. Then I need shadow here too. Share. And I have shadow here as a well. I need to erase. Light that I have painted in. No. Soften it, soften the light. Some artists make use textures to paint in everything, but I'm only a fan of textures in my 3D animations, so I'm not gonna use them there. So this surface is pointing towards me and it's not getting any big highlights, but up here this is getting some. Then again, the light is shining onto here. Maybe a little. Just a little. I used to work with Photoshop. And I tried to get the same results, so like having a brush that blurs the color like that. It you couldn't do it in Photoshop with a brush. And that's why I stayed with Krita. Krita. How do you pronounce it? Krita. I think in English the pronunciation isn't wrong either way, because English has so many different ways to pronounce things. Like just the difference between British and American English. Like when they say the difference between water and I mean water in British and in American. Like they say like in in Britain they say water, right? And in America they say water. And I'm like, And like England is more like so, no. You're not supposed to say it like that. Like that. Oh dear. Hold on, I try to translate that.
Hold on.
That sentence is weird. I love you, I'm the original daughter of my family. What has that one thing to do with the other? Oh, Google is just messing up the translation.
Who knows?
Or is this an attempt of leaving the country? Luckily, I am an independent person and I'm not really in need of someone else. Hold on. Okay, so plastic has this hard glossy surface, so there's no no diffuse light, so I can just continue the feet. Just like the claws, they don't have, they are also glossy. That's basically what you just need to understand. If you are painting light, the light that hits the surface, then the amount of energy is the same and it gets scattered. Depending on how rough the surface is. And the more scattered the light gets, the darker it is. Yeah. So if you have a, hold on. So if you have a surface that is very, that has a high of, what's it called? A high surface area. Then the light gets scattered more, and if you shine light on it, it doesn't light up as much as if the area is more glossy. If you have a more glossy area, a more glossy surface, then that light is more concentrated on the point where it hits the surface directly. I should have made the shadow painting with this brush, then the other. Honestly, what the heck are people from Thailand doing? I'm the first daughter of my father. Yes. Of whoever. Probably. She was trying to find a way out of Thailand or Vietnam or wherever that Nguyen names come from. It's one of those countries where these, where they have this name primarily. Okie dokie, who knows. So I start where the light hits the surface the most, and I'm going from there, like so. Then I can just blend it, and suddenly it becomes more realistic and plastic. And that's something I really struggled at the beginning. Ugh. And you're constantly learning. This is the difference between me and people who say I could never draw like that. People that say I could never draw like that are probably also people that never try. I mean, I've never backed out when something like that happens. So when there was a situation where I had to say I could never do that, I was like, or am I? In the end, it came. It basically came to it that I just said, well, either I want to do it or don't, but never can is nonsense. Because you obviously can learn everything, mastering it and actually doing it is something else. So the pants here are obviously again fabric, which has a high thing, surface area. It has a high thing. Is your thing also so high?
What?
Okay, hold on. I need shadow on my pants. Yeah, I should. Definitely should use this brush more often. It is cleaner. So hold on. Let's see. Got the pants like that. This is a button that is also glossy and therefore not things, you know, not getting any diffuse. Metal. I never painted metal before. Metal. I mean, jeans is a very rough fabric, so I shouldn't actually make it soft lighting here. But then I would have to do all those texturing too. But I don't wanna do that. Cause I'm too lazy. I mean, I wanna get done with the picture at some point. That's my pictures where you see where you see textures, they are a lot more worth. So don't go around and say, oh, these pictures aren't worth anything, when they are. Hold on. I'd rather take this one. Wonder, did I delete the shadow there? Yes. Okay, okay, excellent. Excellent. Not. Did you know that SNL invented Wayne's World? I didn't. And I was watching SNL's Wayne's World episodes that they produced since 1990. With an episode from 2015. Gee, I was very sloppy here. Interesting how people from Thailand enter my stream.
Please marry me.
Oh jeez. Yeah. If someone says I love you in chat and says something like my father is this and that, don't take it. And by the way, hold on. I'm not the guy that wants to get married at some point in life. Because marriage is an antiquated practice. You just do it because it's tradition. And yeah, to be fair, there's no reason to do that anymore. Because if you know why they did it all the way back when people weren't as informed, they basically just did it because they wanted security. For the children, so that the children know who was actually their father and mother. And these two people, so father and mother, were together for at least 18 years, so that the child had his parents and not the wrong ones. It was just a safety measure. But if you look at nature, what animals do, like primates, they actually, hold on, they mate with everybody. Because that is the most effective way to make sure that the species is not going extinct. So make kids as long as you can. As long as it's safe, as long as you have enough food, enough money, and don't make them if you don't. So only make kids if you can actually provide enough food for them. Hold on. Again. If you're a musician and you make music that you like yourself, then you've really hit the jackpot. I mean, from that game for Music 2000. He's a cult. Dirty. Watch Turbo Team. And you get your guy becoming a car. but I already made some of those into a truck, for example. Problem with these is that you don't really know what to make what into what. So, do I make the eyes to the windows or to the headlights? I mean, I always had this idea of turning people into turbo jets. Making them like making the head grow long and what happens to the mouth then? That's everything that needs to be considered there. But it's a lot more difficult because it's not just a transformation from one vertebrae to another vertebrae. I mean, you have suddenly a character becoming a machine. And it doesn't fit into my expertise because I'm uh, specialized into realistic transformations and a transformation into a plane or into a car. That's not really realistic, you know? I mean, it's certainly doable for me. I could do it. Maybe I will do it. Would be something different. The question is, what car? Or am I free to choose? Make him into a Lamborghini, oh dear. And then, yeah. I mean, if you say do make him into a car, yeah, okay. So choice is mine. So, if it's just a question if I can do it, so the ability to, then yeah, sure, I can do that. So I'm able to do it. But you rather want to know if I actually am going to, or I'm willing to. So let's see. No, the tail is in shadow. Do I have everything? No, I don't. So many furry characters. That's why he just got his fur on the back and he too. Okay, so wait. Yes. Hold on. Now we need to this one. This is the highlight, but it's not the highlight, it's the brightest light, where the light concentrates on one. Hi, what's up? Hi, everybody. Well, now the people are tuning in. Please only speak English. Only English, please. International language, please. I don't understand the rest. Let me try to translate that. Hey, let's see which languages. Hungary, huh? Well, I am partly Hungarian. My grandfather came from Hungary. Yeah, but I don't speak any Hungarian. But I'm also hungry. Dad jokes aside. So. But yeah, that's my grandfather. He was from there. Hold on. I write. I have Hungarian ancestry. Okay, I copy that. And how am I writing that in chat? Dang it. I try. Hold on. There you go. I hope Google translated it correctly. I have no idea. Then he's like super insulted. How dare you? Oh, I forgot to light this here. How dare I? Damn. Only German. German. one thing about Hungarians. Whenever I go to a restaurant that serves Hungarian food, they all expect me to like spicy food. I hate spicy food, it's so annoying. I mean, how do people actually like that and ignore the unpleasant feeling spicy food creates? I don't actually know. Or why are they thinking that? Am I the only one? home. Alright, now I have the light done, I think. Well, if not, I can continue. Next, we get to ambient occlusion, which is the shadowy area. The shadowy area's shadow. These shadows are always blurry. It's the shadow in the creases. Basically the lines I draw here are basically also ambient occlusion. Still have to what's the word? I forgot that word. Word is the bird. Bird, bird, bird. The word is the bird. Well, I have to make sure that the shadow has the correct shadow color. It's not like wrong. There we go. This gives the character even more depth, and the best part is yet to come. Don 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 don. I mean the hair are filled with ambient occlusion. Yeah, ambient occlusion heaven, basically. That's why I just slapped that in first. No, not MM. AO. AO stands for ambient occlusion. That's what I'm currently painting. Honestly, this is... Thank you. I could make it dark here, but that wouldn't be correct. Because the further away an object is, the less the ambient occlusion effect is. Let me just fill it in completely. It's just an experiment right now. And paint in the light parts. I used the wrong color. What you're talking about, man? Something you wouldn't like, but... Are you talking about the music or about the image? Save. So now comes reflective light. Yeah. This works.
Yep,
it is working. But not here, because so to get more reflective light, you have to actually take the light from the surroundings and reflect it onto them. That means that we have to make the background now. Then I'm making things, the background. No, no, exactly what kind of background that is. I need a vanishing point. I know exactly where the horizon is. Something that's only possible on a globe Earth. And now, because I said it under my video, it says flat globe Earth, flat Earth. So sad. So we need a street. Hold on. Hold on. Hey, set B. Okay, what am I supposed to do with this with that road? Hmm.
Hi.
Okay, so there is...
House needs some windows. What am I doing? Yes, what am I doing actually? Why am I? That's supposed to be a street. Gets warm. Let me look. Oh, I need to take a break. How do I show people that I am taking a break? I have no sign. I know. Oh, Eddie Winters. He wants to see that I am making transformation videos. Eddie, I'm making transformation videos, but they are not so easily done, so you gotta let me have my time. So you don't want me to rush them, do you? Why am I coloring in that one first? Stupid. Besides, this is a hobby. This is not the job I'm doing. Okay. You gotta have to let me make my own thing. Time to time. I mean, I'm not working on weekends. Then again, it's not weekend anymore. Hold on. This house, I'm better to be patient, yes? You're very demanding. How about you do them yourself? If you want them so much. I mean, it can't be just me doing them. So let's see, how am I summarizing? Get the house here. Like that. This is grass. I mean, I'm not only producing animations. The music you're hearing is also my creation. Oops. An animation without music is shitty. I mean, animation without sound is shitty. Do the host DF with sound. And I'm not the one making the sound. I outsource that, and that outsourced person isn't doing anything. Why? To be fair, I really... Oh, I see. I really don't like making that horse. There, yes. So listen, I am currently working on a snake transformation, and I have built every single scale of the body. And that's very... took me a long time. Additionally, I was also moving to a new place. Then my computer broke down and I had to set it up a complete new system. And yeah. Okay. That was something that's really annoying. So you're saying I'm talented, huh? The thing is, looks like you would just fall down. No, that's not correct. Well, actually, it doesn't have to do with talent. It's basically just practicing for years. I'm doing this for 26 years now. Well, I mean, I'm drawing. The drawing is what I'm doing for 26 years, and painting I'm not doing so long. Music I'm also not doing that long. Doki, let me think. Honestly, I wish transformations would be a lot easier to make. I mean, especially when it comes to cloth ripping. That's something that's holding me back, actually. So I have so many different characters ready, but just because cloth ripping simulation is not really sophisticated enough in Blender, I almost can't do anything, can't work on anything, and I have to manually rip the clothes, which is not really realistic. So for instance, if the character, like in the horse transformation, where you can see how he's flexing the biceps to blast open the arm, I had to animate it until a certain point, and then I had to manually open holes, and then I have to reactivate the cloth simulation. Yeah, and that was this. Now I need to make the ocean.
Jeez, I don't.
Yeah, by the conversion I already lost my previous color palettes. I had to redo them and I am missing the colors for the ocean. Something like that. Okay. Hold on, the window. Window color is white. Okie dokie, okie dokie dokie. Look. So the building is orange, yellow, bluish. Wait, one. So this is a slightly slanting. Okay, hold on. That's how it's done. So we take. Hold on. I'm doing those on a separate layer. Hold on. Just think now. Let's see. Where are the cracks? Well, to be honest, I actually don't need them because I'm blurring the background. So, but I want to have some variability in the background. What are you? Splat, noise, texture big. What does it mean? Texture big. What is it? Right. Let's go up. Warmer. Up. Warmer. Let me think. The floor, the ground, the street, I mean. No, that's dark already. Would have to paint in. It's the same color. No! No! Get to the chopper. It doesn't matter back there because it gets blurry. And now! I'm using this brush. Make some clues. What the heck? Huh? Interesting. Oh, I'm on the wrong thing. Salame. Okay, so the sun comes from there, so the light is kind of like going back like this. But then I would destroy the texture I have made here. No! Well. There we go. I guess. Okay, the houses need shadow too. Not erase. Okay, and since we have that, hold on. Now we need reflective paint here, so hold on. Thank you. Then we paint in some clouds. Then we lower the opacity. Let me think. Okay, okay, so something I need to put in now is a reflective light that is coming from around them. So many light passes. Percent it was. So like you. So when the surface points upwards, you get the light coming from the sky. That's where you. Color in the shadowy areas here. T-shirt. Hold on. That's not the ambient. And there you see how the light comes from atop. You basically do that with every surface that faces the sky. Except when that surface is somehow blocked by something else. So the tail obviously I see that there is a little bit of shadow from the background. Okay, so that's the sky. Now the ambience from around. A little bit saturated and feel a little bit brighter. So his body obviously reflects light too, and that's where I am reflecting upwards. The sky is obviously reflecting in the eye. And then the concrete area is here. Just spread everything. Thank you. Okay, so we have this. So we can see that the light is hitting here, so that is bouncing onto the shirt. And into the arm. Obviously reflecting onto here too. Let me think. So we've got the pants here. I don't know. Well, the ground obviously can reflect some light upwards. But it's not light if it's not over 50%, so it's not reflecting anything up. There we go. Pants are reflecting onto the fingers some light. This again. This is what I like at painting, when you do this, when you're doing this single step, and it actually, this is the reason why those images look so three-dimensional. So hold on. So this is metal. How am I supposed to draw that? I don't know. I'm so unsure. Just light that up a little bit. If there's no light coming here, I mean, this is an area where light doesn't reach. So should I put in some ambient occlusion? I mean, it is obviously not a flat surface. Thank you. So, oh yes, I painted onto him from that. But I didn't paint him anything here, so I'm... Back has obviously some ambient reflection. He receives more light because it doesn't have like wings that block him. I don't understand anything. You, you're writing stuff and I don't understand what anything of that says. I will seek for Chandler. And then Eva. And then yes for you. Bo Fifth got tear for this. What? Please, English! Please, English! Yeah, wrong English. Okay, now the skin color is subtle and then
Let's see. He needs some.
I want this to have some lights, but it's again this dark area where no light reaches. Ah, I see. Here, light. Let's see. I think there should be a tree.
What kind of a tree is that?
Just wait.
No! This is a shit tree. I'm following you.
Whatever.
What?
There, tree. So now the tree needs a shadow. I combine those layers. So, why do I have a line there? Okay, so... now, here's the thing. That would be wrong. I mean, do I really have to select and blur by hand? Dang it. Because the this building here needs to be blurred much less than those objects back there. Lens blur to Isn't there some sort of perspective?
Angular, Bloom, Gaussian. Ah, linear is just like movement. What happened? No. Angular blur is just radial. So if you want to have something rotating. Bloom is just glow. And depth of field is basically what I want. Boulevard. Hold on, I think I know. So the second radius is horizontal, no it's not. Blur is too strong here. User defined, hold on, depth of field bottom layer, so I can define via a black and white image where the depth of field has to be. I think in that case I have to hold on. Okay, wait a second. So to figure out how this works, let me just try something. So if I select both and make filter. It says bottom layer.
You can specify your own depth of field image as a bottom layer image whose luminance encodes the depth for each pixel. Don't forget to modify the input layers combo box to make this layer active for the filter. Huh? So it says luminance, so it's actually really black to white. The bottom layer. Should I name it like that? I don't know. Yes. It's just supposed to be named bottom layer. Ah. And you can see, not fully. So, white means completely blurry, and black means not blurry at all.
Yay!
So, now I need to figure out how to actually do that. So this is one. So the middle is meant to be not blurry at all. I would. So black is not blurry at all. Let's do it like this. Then. This one becomes fuzziness off. There we go. Then select these. Then it's supposed to go towards more blurry. So yes, like that. Hold on. This, then that's going to be white, and the street is going from white all the way
to select the tree too. No. Or do I? But the sky is white. Or is it? No, wait. There's no, yes it is. This is so difficult.
So, now this is going to be going from almost white to black, and the black's like on other way. That's more like it. And now the trick of the century. And that's a white image. Now I've got gimmick. Okay. Okay, so I was a little bit too quick. Start gimmick. I need to tone down the amount of blur. But you can see that it works. let's see. Yeah, like that. That's it. Image is done. All what's missing is my Tony. Let's see, so this is like, okay. So it needs to be a lighter color.
Now save it, then scale it, because it's 3700 times 380, 33. So scale, then have it. So only I own the originals. Let me just think. Okay, hold on, this is just the image, so I'm doing some color dodge and burn. Let's see if I have to do anything. I mean, sure. And let me look at a burn mask too. So what this does is, I'm not sure. It makes it a little bit brighter, and I mean that area is already light. Let me look at the histogram if I find it. Wonder if Krita even has a histogram. It does. Come here, Instagram. All right, so this is without dodge and burn. This with burn. This is with dodge. So without it, it's a little bit too, it's a little bit too thing. I mean, you can clearly see that it is going more towards the length, and it cuts, it's cutting off the colors. That's what dodge does. So without it, we have like almost no, except blue is in the lightest range, and it's pretty, yeah, there's a lot of yellow obviously here and there, the most part is in this lower darker area because of the shadow parts in here. So it's quite balanced. So if I would add dodge, it would just move everything further right. So that dodge mask needs to be a little bit darker. Let's see if I there we go. Now it's squished a little bit more and the color is a lot more balanced. If I add the burn, it goes more to the left and you can see that the colors are going up at this part, which is something that shouldn't happen. So I will leave it at this. So Alt-FX and where are you guys? Up there. Save it. Yes, okay. And that is it. Took me like 8 hours to paint this one image out of nothing. Yay, finally I can do things like 3D animation again. I learned certainly some things and I will be posting it on my DeviantArt. So, how do I so that's that, and is there actually anyone there? No. Well, I'm ending the stream. Goodbye. And like and subscribe. Please.